because she's a fighter, said we are preserving to give everything, everyone his rights.
Can you speak? Yeah. So when people say there is no justice for Allah doing this,
you know, because Allah, Allah knows what he deserves, what and what he deserves. Allah gives everyone what he deserves.
And when we say he deserves that, doesn't mean Allah hates him. Meaning he deserves to be chopped. For example, if Allah punishes, if Allah tries someone using his leg, when we say, doesn't mean he deserves it, meaning he's evil. No, meaning that Allah tried him with that. If he's patient upon that, he will get a place in Jannah. Understand? So, alhamdulillah, this is it. That's why all of us, especially us, go to school, some of us go to schools, colleges, universities, we have to learn this thing of Allah. And learn by reading and studying. For example, let me be honest, brothers and sisters. Yeah? What I've noticed, when you put a video of debate or discussion, many people watch it. But if you put a video, teach it from a book, less people watching it. But the true knowledge, where is the true knowledge? It's in the videos when the when people are going through books of Aqidah, books of Manhaj, books of expression of the Quran. That's the true knowledge. Why? That's how you become mu'assal, well-grounded in ilm. In the debates, you learn here and there, but when you study the deen correctly, step by step, that's how you become well-grounded. That's when you start dealing with every shubha, even though you don't know every shubha, because why? You have which is called general response. You have the usul. When you have the usul, then you can deal with every misconception by taking it back to the usul. You know? Because there are two types of responding to doubt. General response and a specific response. General response, you take it back to the usul. A specific response when you deal with every doubt and misconception separately. Understand? So we, alhamdulillah, as Muslims, we advise one another. Watawasaw bis sabri, watawasaw bil haqq. That's the teaching of Islam. And Islam is not about just come to the park, give da'wah, you don't pray. You don't fast. You don't pray night prayer. You don't, no. Islam is Deen wa dunya. Deen wa dunya. You have to live it. You know, act upon it. According to our abilities. Of course, we're not perfect. That's understandable. You know, that's clear. But, you know, some people come to the park. You see him giving da'wah. Akhi, it's time for asr. He's not praying, no asr. Maghrib, akhi. No maghrib. Brother, do you pray? No. That's not. This is some backward teaching. That's not teaching. قل هذه سبيلي أدعو إلى الله على بصيرة أنا ومن اتبعني وسبحان الله وما أنا من المشركين. That said is my path. The Messenger of Allah said, Allah to him said is my path. I call to my Lord. You know, على بصيرة upon insight. العلم قبل القول والعمل. Knowledge precede action and speech. So you have to have a knowledge, then act upon it. Not act upon something, then you start looking who is the proof for it. That's backward. Knowledge, then act upon the knowledge. That's the, that's how we learn our deen and we get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know? When we come here, we are, and look, the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ. Actions is based upon intentions. ولكل امرئ ما نوى. Every person where he intends or where she intends. So when we come to the park, you know, like if you have knowledge, I wouldn't advise people to come to the park, seriously. But if you do come, listen to people who are known to be open to clarity. Those who go to Ahl Sunnah. Those are listening to Hatun, or those are listening to people with doubt, misconceptions, people with misguidance, you know? Why? Because you want to make sure that you're taking the correct ilm, the correct knowledge. And if you come and there's no brothers who are not to the Quran Sunnah, you know, then it's better off you go home with the Quran. Just walking around, better off to go read the book of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. A hadith of Mustafa alayhi salatu wa salam. My ahsan. You know, ahsan. Because the problem with the park, as I say, side effect of the park, you start getting used to people insulting Allah and His Messenger. Your khira start getting riyadu billah and it's dangerous. Start thinking it's okay. Now we get upset. But we're not going to use our hands because against the law. know, this anger is the law. But we dislike it. Likewise, if you insult Allah's messenger and you've been, people spoke to you and they clarified, but you're still doing it, don't expect us to smile with you outside. We're not going to harm you, we're not going to smile with you. Understand that?
Muhammad.